Good morning. So here we will discuss some of the programs related with 8051. Okay, so programming with 8051 will verify using Keil Simulator 2. Okay, so before that, the first program, before discussing the first program, the first thing we need to discuss here is produce a delay. How to produce delay using microcontroller 8051. Okay, using microcontroller 8051. Right. So now, whatever frequency the crystal oscillator pin in the pin diagram, namely XTAL1 and XTAL2, these two crystal oscillator will be these two pins will be having a crystal oscillator. Okay, these two pins will be having a crystal oscillator, and then crystal oscillator. So in our laboratory we have the crystal oscillator frequency is 11.0592 megahertz. Okay, megahertz. Megahertz. 1 machine cycle, each and every instruction will be executed based on the machine cycle, will be executed based on the machine cycle. Each and every instruction, each and every instruction will be executed based on the time. Okay, like the human being is associated with our clock, the human being is associated with our own clock. The operation related with so 1 machine cycle in 8051 processor is having, controller is having 12 clock cycles. So each clock cycle you have an on and the off, you have an on and the off, and then 1 machine cycle for this type of crystal oscillator frequency is 11.0592 megahertz divided by 12. Okay, the time period for the 1 machine cycle will be inverse of this function. Inverse of this function, that will be around, if you calculate, that will be 1.0855 microseconds. Okay, 085 microseconds. So with this thing, we will discuss how to produce the delay. Okay, in 8051 microcontroller. So write a program to generate a square waveform of 3 kilohertz in port pin P0.1 using 8051 microcontroller. Assume the crystal oscillator frequency as 11.0592 megahertz. Okay. So before discussing this, we need to generate a square waveform, right? We need to generate a square waveform. So generation of this square waveform, you have to generate a square waveform. So let me generate a square waveform of 3 kilohertz as I said, okay, with 50% duty cycle, meaning same on time and off time, on time and off time. Okay. So this one, in bit port P0.1, okay, so P0.1 will be having 1 for quite some time. This time, after that, P0.1 should be 0, it should be 0. So 1 divided by, first thing we need to do is 1 divided by 3000 hertz, that will give you the total time period for this. Okay, for this thing, and then divide by 2. Okay, divide this by 2, load this value in some register, the logic I am telling. Okay, load this value in some register R. After that, the maximum value that could be saved in the register. Okay, it is FFH. Try to decrement the register value. Okay, till then your T0.1 is 1 only. The register value is loaded with the delay. This is your delay. Your on time is your delay. When the register value is 0, you need to toggle the bit, or you need to complement the bit P0.1, and then again you need to come back with the delay. Again you need to come back with the delay. Go ahead with the register content. See to that how much time or the delay that the register can produce if the maximum value is FFH. If the delay is not sufficient, you need to go ahead with the nested loops. Okay, you need to go ahead with the nested loop. Okay, so the maximum number that can be stored in a register, what you need to remember is the maximum number that can be stored in a register is FFH. For a crystal oscillator frequency of 11.0592, you have 1.085 microseconds. Okay, these here I have given the table and each the machine cycle of each instructions, machine cycle of each instructions. So see here, A call instruction is having a two number of machine cycle. It's a 2-byte instruction, meaning the A call instruction, when we are writing program using A call instruction, it will occupy 2 bytes of memory space. It will occupy 2 bytes of memory space. That is what here to specify. See. Okay, 2 bytes of memory space. So see, I have given here complement P0.1, okay, 3000, and then call your delay. Okay, call your delay. So it will be T on plus T off will be 0.3 milliseconds. 3000 is 0.3 milliseconds. So for 0.3 milliseconds by 2, you have to produce a delay. Okay, then complement your P0.1. That is what here CPL P0.1, this instruction we need to use. Okay, how we are going to write the program. So see here, I have written the program. First thing is complement P0.1. Okay, let me assume that P0.1 is having 0. Okay, so if I am complementing that bit, means it will be 1 now. Okay, it will be 1 now. A call delay, absolute call within page call, that is a page call. So A call delay. So whenever you have a call statement, what the compiler will do, the address of the next instruction will be held in the program counter. That value will be stored in the stack such that first is lower order and then is your higher order. Okay, first is lower order and then is your higher order. And then whatever address that is being specified in the delay, that is that will be moved into the program counter, and then you will have a call here. Okay, what is a call? A call delay. Go to the delay routine. That is a routine. Okay, because this process is going to be repeated on and on. Okay, so move R3. I am using the register content R3 for getting the count value. This N value is nothing but the delay value that we need to calculate. Okay, that we need to calculate. So R3 comma ash N. So decrement the register content till it becomes 0. Till it becomes 0, you have to be here only, meaning the T0.1 has to be 1 only. Okay, 1 only. Once it is 0, go to the return. Once if you have a return, what does the compiler will do? It will take the address from PCH, from the stack pointer, the PCH and PCL, and it will be loaded in the stack program counter, and then your control will be transferred to the main program. It will come here, sjump instruction. What does sjump says? Short jump, jump again. It is an unconditional jump here. Sjump again, it will go to the again. What here will be doing? It will complement the bit P0.1. What is there already? It is 1. What will be now? It will be 0. Okay, again go for the delay. Do the delay calculation till it becomes, the register R3 becomes 0. And then go ahead. Like that, the same operation will be done again and again to produce the square waveform. Okay. So now how you are going to calculate the delay? As I said, we need to go ahead with the subroutine, the move instruction. Okay. The move instruction. This has one machine cycle. Okay. Move instruction will be having one machine cycle, whereas the decrement jump on non-zero and a return statement will be having two machine cycles. See here, decrement will be having two and return is having two machine cycles. See, the return is having two machine cycles. So the move instruction will be one. Decrement jump on non-zero will be done for n number of times, where n is the count value, okay, the register value. So n into 2 plus 2, okay, plus 2 should be 0.3 by 2 milliseconds. Okay, should be 0.3 by 2 milliseconds. So calculate the value of n in decimal and then make it hexadecimal and then store it in your program. Check your program. Okay. So, if the delay is not sufficient, if n value is greater than 255, because only till FF you can store in a register. When your n value is greater than 255, you need to use nested loops. Okay. So, you have two register content registers or three registers or n number of registers you can use for producing nested loops. It's like in C programming, you have two for loops, like nested for loops. In the same way, you will be using decrement, two decrement jump on non-zero instructions for two registers, and then you will be going ahead with the nested loops. Okay. Yeah, guys, I have calculated the delay, n value, the count value, and I have written the program here, okay, in keel. So, see here, I am complementing the port bit P1, I am complementing the port bit P1, and I am calling the subroutine, A call subroutine, the subroutine name is delay, and then S jump again. So, first let me call the delay. So, if I call the delay, I am using the nested loop, I am using two register, R2, 17 decimal, I am feeding into R2, and similarly for R3, I am inserting 17 decimal. And then I am decrementing R3 first, that is the innermost loop. Once R3 is becoming 0, it will come out and then decrement R2 and go back to move R3, 17. So it will complete the inner loop and then go again and again for 17 times. The outer loop is 17 times, inner loop is 17 times, and return to the main program, where it will return. It will automatically, it will take the program counters, program counters 16-bit address from the stack, and then whenever a return statement is executed, and then it will go back to, and then it will go back to the main program. So where it will go? It will go for S jump again. Where is again? It is again complementing the bit port P1.0. So initially, if P1 is equal to 0, if P1 is equal to 0 and P1.0 is equal to 0, then after complementing, it will be P1.1 is equal to 1. Okay. So let me run this program. So, this one, again, rebuild, and then go for debug. And then, run. After that, after running it, go for this analysis window. Click on the logical analyzer. See, in the setup, what I need to do is I need to create a new. Let me create it and show you. So P1.0. Okay, P1.0. It's already there because I have done it. It's a bit type display. And then color, you can fix the color. I have fixed it as green and click it on OK. And then what I will do, let me remove one of the port. OK, let it be like this. Stop. Use stop. And then go for the trace. And keep the cursor here. So come here to the one time fully. See here. So delta value is 1514, which is around 1.5 kilohertz. What is our question? The question is we need to generate a square waveform of 3 kilohertz with 50% duty cycle. So it is around 1.5 kilohertz. We won't get exactly 1500 hertz. Okay, the calculation may differ. So it is on time 1.5 means off time will also be 1.5. So it is generated. A square waveform is generated at P0.1. Is it okay? Okay. Okay, guys. Let us see the next program. What is the next program? Write a program to find the largest number in a given array. The array, you can even assume 100 numbers. Okay. But what I am going to explain is I am going to take only 10 number. I am going to the numbers, the assumption is the numbers are stored from 3EH. The numbers are stored from 3EH. I am assuming that the numbers are stored from 3EH. So let me share the program with you. Numbers are stored from 3EH. Okay. So first let me set up the memory location in the register R0. Okay. So the register R0 contains the memory location. From starting from 3 onwards, 10 numbers are stored. And from that memory location, you need to compare the numbers. Okay. So how many numbers you are going to compare? 10 numbers. So R1 register will act as a counter. So move R1, 10. Okay. It can be 10 decimal. Okay. Right. So now I am going to clear the register B. Okay. Clear the register B. Move B, 00H. And then I am going to move the data available at R0, which is nothing but 3EH to R0. I mean 3EH, whatever data that is being pointed out by R0 in 3EH, the data, let us move it to A. So now A has a data that is available in 3EH and B has a data of 00H. Compare, jump on non-zero. Compare it. Compare will do subtraction, A minus B. Okay, if both the results are 0, what the compare, jump on non-zero. If the both the results are not 0, jump to the loop 1. Okay, they are not equal. That is the meaning. It is not equal. It is not equal. So go to loop 1. What is loop 1? Loop 1 is here. Increment your R0. Increment your R0. Compare, jump, not equal. It is not a 0, not equal. So when you compare, so now 00 is not equal to the content available in 3EH. When that is not equal, sorry, I have said non-zero, it is not equal. So when they are not equal, what it is, again 00, and let the first data be available in A is 22. Okay, compare 22 and 00, definitely they are not equal. So go back to the loop. Where is loop? Loop is somewhere here. Okay, so if it is not equal, set your carry, jump on carry. Okay, go to your loop. What I'll do here, jump on carry loop 1. Compare those two numbers, either it is greater or lesser. Okay, accordingly your carry flag is set to 1. Go to loop 1. What is your loop 1? If your carry flag is set, meaning the data available in A is greater. The data available in A is greater. So we can keep as such. So that increment R naught. So the second number we need to pick. So increment your R naught. So 3EH from 3EH to 3F. 3F. So decrement jump on non-zero R1. Then what is your R1? The counter value, right? The counter value. Increment your data. You need to pick up the next data that is available in 40 and decrement your counter value, because already we took one number. So we need to decrement it to 9, from 10 decimal to 9 decimal. And then go back, again go back. And what is your current memory address? 3F. From 3F, move the data here. Okay, move the data here. Jump on not equal. Okay, jump on not equal. So if they are not equal, go to the loop again. When there is a carry, you need to jump to loop one. When there is no carry, move the greatest number, because it means that A is comparing A with B. Okay, comparing with A with B. Now A is greater, so whatever content available in A, move it to B. The greatest number, you move it to B. Again, do the same operation. Increment your R naught. 3F to 40, and then decrement jump on non-zero back. So decrement jump on non-zero R1. So R1 has to be decremented. Already it is 9, now it is 8. Again, go back and do the same operation. Okay. So how to run this? So let me run one. So now, before after debugging, I need to save the data from 3E. So 3E00 3EH. So 3 is here. So let me save 12, 13, 14, and then 54. Then 40 56 45 32, randomly I'm giving some numbers. Okay, 22. So 2 4 6 8, two numbers I need to give. 11, and then 4 7. Okay, let me take 10 numbers. Let me run now. What is the among this error, which is the greatest number? 56 is the greatest number. That should be saved in B, because B register is holding the biggest number. See here, I did a total run, because here we are using a counter, no? Like 10 times, if I do step execution, it will be tougher. Like it will be time consuming. So A register will be having 47. The next, B register will be having the largest number. The next largest number will be held in A. So I think so. It's not the next largest number. It is the last number of the memory location. Okay, this is the last number of memory location. 47 is held in A, and the largest number is stored in B. That is 56. Okay, I think you got it. The R0 register is having the last address, which is nothing but the 48. Okay, the address. So with this, I'll stop for the programming section. That too, we have used call and subroutine for the delay calculation of a program, where we generated a square waveform with 50% duty cycle. And the second program, we have used the compare instructions. Compare instruction and jump on carry, conditional jump we have used. Okay, and then we have even used increment and increment instructions, arithmetic instructions. So increment the content by 1. Okay, so with that we have done the program. Thank you. I hope you have understood.